That ship is the Mebo 2, better known as Radio North Sea International. She's moored some 9 miles off the Dutch coast, and since last Saturday has been transmitting regular pop pirate broadcasts in English and German. The company that runs her is Swiss, and the ship itself is serviced from Holland, so there's no direct connection with the British Isles.
But the British Ministry of Posts and Telecommunications sees the ship as an attempt to beat the legislation which put the other pirates off the air 2 years ago. The Council of Europe agreement made at that time can stop contact with pirate stations from countries who've ratified the agreement. Holland hasn't, and doesn't plan to just yet. Much of the North Sea radio advertising is expected to come from Japan, and Britain could find that difficult to stop.
Broadcasting 5 miles off the coast of Holland from the motor vessel Mebo 2, this is the town of Europe on 186 metres, Radio North Sea International. Music 19 hours a day, especially for you. Right now, though, I'd like to say hello to Mrs. Gloria Swallow up there in Ipswich in Suffolk. Very nice to hear from you.
So far, most of the advertising space is being given away.
This is Radio North Sea International, an SOS call. This is Mayday, 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 Radio North Sea International from the Mebo 2 at exactly 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude, 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude, 4 degrees, 16 minutes longitude, 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude, 4 degrees, 16 minutes longitude. 4 miles from the coast of Scheveningen, Holland. 1 mile from the radio ship Norderney, Veronica. We are having to abandon ship very soon. The bridge and the engine room are on fire. The fire is taking control of the ship. The fire was caused by a bomb.
Let your mind take up in flight. Why don't you try it now? See how the colors of the rainbow. Beautiful, covering the people that we know. See the color of your hair flowing from your older self. Why don't you try it now? Maybe you could stop playing games, traveling the astral planes. Why don't you try it now?
This is Radio North Sea International, an SOS call. This is Mayday, 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 Radio North Sea International from the Mebo 2 at exactly 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude, 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude, 4 degrees, 16 minutes longitude, 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude, 4 degrees, 16 minutes longitude. 4 miles from the coast of Scheveningen, Holland. 1 mile from the radio ship Norderney, Veronica. To abandon ship very soon. The bridge and the engine room are on fire. The fire is taking control of the ship. The fire was caused by a bomb thrown on board from a small motor ship. A small motor launch with an outboard motor. A small motor launch with an outboard motor. We don't know who it belongs to. We don't know where it came from or where it's going to. But it certainly bombed us while it was here. Fire caused by a bombing in the engine room on Radio North Sea International, the radio ship Mebo 2. Once again, our exact position, please listen carefully, 52 degrees, 11 minutes north latitude, 4 degrees, 16 minutes longitude, west, I'm sorry, east, 4 degrees, 16 minutes east longitude, 52 degrees, 11 minutes latitude north. This is the Mebo 2, this is the Mebo 2 on fire. This is the Mebo 2 on fire. SOS, Mayday, 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 SOS. This is an SOS call from Radio North Sea International. Once again, we have trouble. Somebody's bombed us this time. 4 miles from the coast of Scheveningen, the radio ship Mebo 2 is on fire. We need help immediately. We need help immediately. International broadcast in the medium wave at 220 meters, 1367 kilohertz. Shortwave 6205 kilohertz, 49 meters European band. FM channel 44, 100 megahertz. Please stay tuned to these three frequencies for further information. Please write down this telephone number and call it immediately. Zurich 542447. Mebo 2 is now abandoning ship.
is again Mebo 2. The captain is giving exactly the position again.
Hallo al de luisteraars en al, de positie van de Mebo 2 is 52 graden en 11 minuten. 4 graden en 16 hoogste lengte. Op het ogenblik hebben we een klein schip en een brandboomschip gegooid. Wij missen dringende assistentie. Over. Er was een explosie in de machinekamer. Waarschijnlijk door het gooien van een brandboom. De bemanning gaat nu moment in de lijfboot langzaam. En we wensen hulp van een reddingsboot of een brandblusschip. En er zitten maybe nog vier personen aan boord.
Dat is Gila, Bend Me, Shape Me.
We'll be right back.
Me, Shape Me van Gila.
Gezellig.
Het is altijd gezellig tussen 10 en 11. En voordat de microfoon open ging hadden we een hevige discussie over dames in dameskleding, in rokken dus en jurken. René de Leeuw die prefereert vrouwen in echte vrouwelijke uitvoering. Rob van der Meer ook. En John Anderson die loopt liever in een lange broek. Hey Jan.
It is absolutely freezing here today, despite a pair of long johns and two very strong cups of tea inside me. But could you imagine living out there on the North Sea for a fortnight at a time? That was the zany, wacky, crazy showbiz lifestyle of the DJs of Yorkshire's first pirate radio station, Radio 270. And who better to tell their story than Sir Jimmy Savile?
Free commercial radio on 270, biggest pirate radio. Broadcasting outside territorial waters.
Footsteps in the sand, that's what it was in the 60s, because pirate radio turned up, disc jockeys, marvellous, a whole new revolution. And one of the best was here in Scarborough, Radio 270.
Hello, it's Paul Burnett on the swinging boat off the northeast coast. Radio 270, the station with a smile.
Well, I was struck by how small it was, because we'd seen pictures of Radio Carolina, Radio London, and they were like sort of ocean-going liners compared with this thing. But, you know, I was too excited about the job to really bother about that. I'd hardly left the harbour when it suddenly became very apparent that I was not a good sailor. And I was violently ill, as I say, just as we'd came out of the harbour, so it did cross my mind to think, had I made a wise decision?
Broadcasting from 3.5 miles off the Yorkshire coast, this is Radio 270, I'm Philip Hayton.
The
I mean, it wasn't the most salubrious of ships. It was a converted Dutch herring lugger, a rusty old hulk with this very cramped studio in it. And then we had two crews on board, one a broadcasting crew and one a load of fishermen from Bridlington who used to, you know, man the boat and take it in and out of port occasionally. We all shared one big mess. We had bunk beds there, and we just, you know, lived, ate, sleep, drank radio. Good vibration.